Hey Ramgopal, why do you choose Camtasia for your screen recording when there are other free options available? That's a question I get frequently asked, and in this video, I'll answer that question for you. But before that, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. We thank Camtasia from TechSmith for sponsoring today's video. I'm sure you all agree that when you want to create your tutorial videos, you want your audience to understand your information clearly without straining themselves, or in other words, you want them to have minimum cognitive load in understanding your information. Camtasia helps you achieve that every single time, because Camtasia is not just a screen recording program, it is a video editing program as well. Let me show you four simple reasons why Camtasia allows you to create better tutorial videos when it comes to recording your screen. Camtasia makes it easier to see. Let me explain. Camtasia allows your audience to see certain portions of your screen clearly with its zoom and pan functionality. Since it's highly likely that your audience is watching most of your tutorial videos on their mobile screen, this feature of zooming and panning into certain sections of your screen is extremely important today. Let me show you three quick methods to zoom into certain parts of your screen using Camtasia. Here is a recording of my word screen, and I want to zoom in on this particular group so my audience can understand how the font group works. The first method that I commonly use to zoom into a specific portion of the screen is to go to Animations, click on Zoom and Pan, and then click and drag from the corner so I can show the audience this particular portion quite clearly. Now, once I finish my explanation, I can always click on Scale to Fit and the entire screen is shown. Now, let us say you want to make this a bit more dramatic so your audience understands where this particular portion fits into the overall screen. The method I use for that is I select the specific area of the recording I want to copy. You can see that I've got this area selected. I press Ctrl C to copy and then press Ctrl V to paste. Only this portion is copied and a copy is made here. Now I'm going to click and drag that portion right on top of the area of selection. Now what I've got here is, in this area I have two layers, the base layer and then the copied layer. Now this copied layer can be cropped. Let me deselect that, it doesn't really matter. Now let me click on the preview window. I can click on this button called crop. And then I can click and drag so that I'm able to crop only the portion that I want to show. I can move the playhead to the area where I want to zoom in, then go to Animations, go to Custom, and then click and drag at the beginning. Now I have created a keyframe. Now I can click on the Edit option, and then I can select this portion and I can expand this. From this keyframe onwards, this portion is expanded. And then once I finish my explanation, I can click on Restore and then I can click and bring it back here. Now watch how this portion is shown. When I go here to the playhead and scrub it, this portion is highlighted. And once I finish my explanation, it can be brought back to its original size and the audience knows exactly how this portion fits into the entire screen. Now, if I want to show this piece even more clearly, I can add a border around this area. For that, let me move the playhead onto that particular segment and then go to Visual Effects, go to Border and then place a border around this. And I can change the color of the border to red and then I can increase the size. You can see that we have a clear border here. You can make it even thicker. Now, when I go back and play this again, you can see that that portion is distinguished with a clear red border. Now let me show you the third method to zoom into a specific area. And this one looks quite fancy. Let me move the playhead to the point where I want to show the effect. Then I go to Animations, click and drag Custom. So I create a keyframe here on the timeline. Let me hold both Ctrl and Shift button and click on the screen and then I can just drag my cursor like this so I'm able to rotate the screen like this. And then I can move a bit closer And if I want to scale this further, I can increase the scale like so. And then I can move this in such a way that the audience is able to see this portion very clearly. And once I am done, and if I move the playhead over here, I can go to restore and then click and drag it back onto the timeline. Now watch what happens. You can see we have a 3D rotation of the screen, allowing the audience to see the specific area that they want to focus on, and then we have everything going back to normal. The second reason why I use Camtasia is Camtasia makes it easier for the audience to follow my instructions. Let us say you want to demonstrate a step-by-step method of how to lock track changes in Microsoft Word. The usual way of showing that process is this. Can you see in the large screen the details are getting missed? Let me show you how easy Camtasia makes for the audience to follow instructions with the cursor effects. Here I have got the same procedure demonstrated. The first thing I'm going to do is to increase the size of the cursor. For that, let me click on this track here, then go to this option called Cursor Properties, and then increase the scale to 300% and hit enter. Now my cursor, as you can see here, is fairly big. Then I can go to this pane here and click on cursor effects. If I want to make it even easier for the audience to follow my cursor, I can add a highlight to my cursor. Now watch this. This is my cursor here. I can click and drag this highlight effect and place it on that particular recording. You can see we have a highlight around the cursor. As I scrub the playhead, you can see that my cursor now has a highlight. I can always work with the properties here. If I want to change the color of the highlighter from yellow to some other color, maybe red, I can do so. I'm quite happy with the yellow color that we had earlier. So let me press Ctrl Z and we are back to this colored highlight. If I want to have that a little more transparent, I can reduce the opacity like so, and you can see that the intensity is reduced. Now, some trainers have the habit of moving their cursor way too much on the screen. If you have that habit, you can always go for cursor smoothing option, where the unnecessary cursor movements are curtailed and the cursor moves from point to point. The next thing I'm going to do is to show the audience where left mouse click happens. So let me go to this option here called cursor effects left mouse click, and I'm going to have that indicated with a cue called rings. So let me click and drag that option onto that particular recording again. You can see that we have the second effect shown. Now watch what happens. As I play, as I click, there is a ring that expands. Watch again. Now I go here and I click and click, and every time I click, you have this ring expanding. So the audience very clearly follows every step of the way. And then I can go here, and you can see that I click on this area and I write my password, and once it is done, I click again and the job is done. Now, if you want to take this a little further and you want to have a click sound every time a click is done, you can click and drag this sound and then place it over here. Now observe once again. So can you see here? We have multiple cues for the audience to follow the instructions because of these nice cursor effects in Camtasia. Now, the third reason why I use Camtasia is Camtasia makes it easy for my audience to focus on the specific part of the screen that I want them to focus on. For example, if I want my audience to focus on one particular word called references on the screen, I can do so using the highlighter tool. Let me go to annotations, go to blur and highlight, and click on the highlight option, and then move the highlight so that I am able to bring the attention to just this word. And you can see that for this portion, only that area is going to be highlighted. So just watch this. As I click here, that portion is highlighted quite nicely. Now, as we move further, you can see that on clicking the lock tracking button, this window is shown. I want the audience to to only see this area and not get distracted by the information around it. How can I do that? It's very simple. I can go to annotations once again and use this option called spotlight, and I can place the spotlight over here and then readjust the size like so. And if I want this area to be blurred even further, I can increase the intensity like this. Now watch as I play this. At that point, only that portion is highlighted quite nicely, so the audience can only follow my instruction at that point, and then they can follow the rest of the action. Let me remove this. The same way, if I want to blur a certain portion of the screen, I can use this blur option, and you can see that the audience can't really see that particular area. And if I want that to be pixelated, I can do so as well. Let me delete this option. Let me go to pixelate, and I can expand this. And when I play this, you can see that that portion is pixelated and the audience can't see what is there on that particular area. So all these tools allow me to view the viewer's attention to focus on certain part of the screen that I want them to focus on. The fourth and final reason why I like Camtasia is Camtasia makes it easier for my audience to understand my information. The reason is I can add further information by way of annotations. Let me explain what I mean by that. Let us say we have a recording of a chart as shown here, and I want to add further information that 36% of all the blocks that are published between Tuesdays and Wednesdays. Now I want to add this additional information. I can do so quite nicely. First, I want to draw the viewer's attention to just this portion. So let me go to annotations, and here I have another interesting option called sketch motion callouts. And if I want to draw a small rough looking box around these two columns, I can do so. Just watch this. There is a nice little box that is drawn around this area. So I have got my viewer's attention here. Now I want to add further information. For that, let me go to this option for callouts, and then I can add this option. Now let me move the place where it points to this one, and I can even move the box over here, and then I can write my information here. Now I can reduce the duration of this, and if I want to make that a little more dramatic, I can add a behavior to this. Let me go to behaviors and let us say pop-up behavior on just that portion. Now watch what happens. I draw the viewer's attention here, and then there is this additional pop-up that gives further information to this chart. So even after I finish recording, during the editing process, if I feel like adding more information, I can do so quite elegantly in Camtasia. Now let us say I want to add one more information as a text snippet. I can do so using a lower third. Let me move the cursor over here, and this is the place where I want to add a lower third. Let me go to library, and here I have Camtasia 2021, and I have lower thirds option. I can click and expand this, and there are quite a few beautiful options available. I can click and drag this one, and I can place it over here. And as I move my cursor on this, you can see that this is the lower third. I can always click on this and I can make my change, or I can go here and I can change the title. For example, I can say additional snippet, and this is further info. Now watch this as I play this. So at that point, the additional snippet with further information is shown. Now the question is, can your free screen recording program do all this? Now what I've shown you are just some of the basic functionalities of Camtasia. I've not even scratched the surface of all the things that Camtasia can do to make your tutorials professional. If you want to explore what Camtasia can do for your tutorial videos, you can click on the link in the description box below the video, where you can go to the Camtasia's page and then download a free version of the program and experiment with the various options available. Once you're convinced that this is the program for you to make professional tutorial videos, you can purchase the program using the coupon code that you find in the description box below the video. Camtasia has agreed to extend 10% discount to all our viewers at Presentation Process channel when you use the coupon code in the description below. So go ahead and click on the link below this video and see how Camtasia can change the way you create your tutorial videos.